Okay, update. Yes, we already have an update on the new compost tumbler barrel system that we created. Just a quick look at the stand that we made, which is holding up very well, even after the really bad storm we had. I'm very, very happy with this stand so far. It works very well. But the update here is that these barrels are airtight and watertight, and with the manure in them and the sun beating down on them, it heats up very, very nicely, but the moisture and the steam has nowhere to go. So it just gets hot, 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 and hot, and becomes a little fermented inside. So we had to put a vent on, and we came up with the outdoor dryer vent, and it does have a screen. I'm gonna rotate it around here so that you can see in. Hopefully you can see in there. There's a little screen on there to prevent animals and stuff. Now some insects, flies and stuff will be able to get in there, but that's fine. I kind of like the idea of flies going in and out, and maybe ants or whatever being able to get in there, because that'll help with the composting. But the idea is to keep animals out, like squirrels and chipmunks and rodents and mice. Those we don't want in there. And here, on nice, hot, bright, sunny days, we can keep it vented upwards like this, and as the sun bears down on this barrel and heats it up, which as you can see, hopefully you can tell that it is at an angle, the back end is 10 inches lower than the front end. That's how we designed it. If it was sitting perfectly level, it's designed for that the front is 10 inches higher. Now right now how we got it set on the ground is not level, so it's actually about, the front's actually about 12 inches higher. So that way everything stays tilted to the back, and when you roll it, it kind of mulches it around, mixes it up very nicely. So what that means is when the sun beats down and heats it up, the hot air rises up to here and can come out these vents, and the moisture that's trapped inside there can come out and help with the composting. So there's never too much moisture inside. Moisture is added when we add the fresh compost from the humanure compost from the house. So there you have it. We do also, when we add a load, I'll have to set the camera down for a second so I can open it. When we add a load of compost, there's the inside of the dryer vent thing. Before, when we were doing the compost with the bins back there, we would add hay to it. And doing it in this style, it's easier for us to add either hay or leaves. This particular moment, we have a bunch of leaves because it's springtime. So we got a bunch of decaying forestry debris. So we just put a couple handfuls of leaves in there to help with the woody portion to break it down. And we don't want to just leave the lid off again because the animals and stuff will get in there. But it is working very, very well. And I really am happy with this setup. It's going to be, it takes two hands to put it back on, so I'll wait till the video is over. But it's going to be a much, much more durable, stable, sustainable system here. And this should last a lifetime. Definitely these barrels will last a lifetime for sure. So, alrighty, just wanted to show that. Now on payday, we'll probably pick up a couple more of these. These vents here were $5.30.
I think it was $5.99.
Or $5.99, Addie says. Yeah. So, and the screws I had laying around. So far we've got $14 invested in the barrel, $6 invested in the vent, and I think it was $20 invested in the wood. And then the screws we had laying around, so a couple of dollars in screws. So, still cheaper than purchasing. It's about 50% of the cost. This total cost here is about 50% of the cost of buying that $100 barrel, that tumbler that's sitting over there. So much cheaper. Alrighty, thanks for watching.